हीटिंग एफिशिएंसी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक केटल बाय यूजिंग ए इलेक्ट्रिक केटल एम वी हैव टू स्टडी द हीटिंग एफिशिएंसी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक केटल विथ वेरिंग वोल्टेजेस वस्तुंडले कैमरा वेस्ट सो द अपरेटस यूज्ड इन दिस इज इलेक्ट्रिक केटल थर्मामीटर वेरिएबल एसी वोल्टेज पावर सप्लाई with the voltmeter, clock watch and water. So formula used in this apparatus is the heating efficiency of the electric kettle is given by eta is equal to m into 4.2 into 10 cube into theta into r by v square t into 100%, where m is the mass of the water. So m w2 minus w1, where w1 is the mass of the empty kettle and W2 is the mass of the kettle plus water. V is voltage applied in volts. T is equal to time of flow in current in seconds. R is equal to resistance of the coil of the kettle in ohms. Theta is the rise in temperature. So this value is obtained by theta 1 is the initial temperature, theta 2 is the final temperature. Then by subtracting theta 2 minus theta 1, we get the value of theta. Theta is the electrical efficiency of the kettle in percentage. Theta 1 is the initial temperature, theta 2 is the final temperature. Now, I explain how the efficiency of the electric kettle is determined by using the apparatus. So first of all, the mass of the empty kettle is determined by using a rough balance like this with stirrer, and after that take some water in the kettle. And place again on the rough balance. Now the mass of the electric kettle with water is W2. So W1 is empty and W2 is the with water. So subtracting these two values, we get the small m in the formula. Now by using the electrical circuit, the voltage is applied in the electric kettle. Say first of all, set into the voltage 100 volts in the voltmeter. Now current is passing through the kettle and heated up. First of all, by using the thermometer, the initial temperature of the water is determined like this. Say the temperature is theta 1 degree centigrade, and like this 5 minutes after time, like this 5 minutes of time is current is passing through it, and again after 5 minutes that is first of all the mass of the calorimeter is kettle is determined by using the balance. Then first of all the voltmeter is start, and again the stop clock is started at the same time. Now the time is measured by using the stop clock. So let us consider 5 minutes of time is current passing through it. So after 5 minutes again stop the voltage and take 5 minutes from the stop clock, and again also stop. After 5 minutes the temperature is again noted. Say it is temperature is now T2. So now they get, so as shown in the experiment, first of all voltage value is 100 volts. So time is suppose 6 seconds, suppose 3 minutes
then 3 into 60, that means 180 seconds. Next of initial temperature is 21, and after 5 minutes the final initial temperature is 29, and after 5 minutes the temperature rises to 35 degrees centigrade. So the difference of these two readings which gives the 6 degrees. So now the substitute value of mass, that is m, which is obtained by the subtracting W2 minus W1, where W1 is the mass of the empty calorimeter, empty kettle, and M1 is the empty kettle, M2 is with water. Subtracting these two values, we get the value of small m, and theta is the raise in temperature already obtained in the last column, and R is the resistance, that is the standard value, whole by V square T, that means the voltage applied. V square T means the time. Time means, suppose here the time is in 180, so that value substituted here, then we get the efficiency of the electric kettle heater. So like this, for different voltages, that means we can change the values 100, after that 120, 140, 160, and each time the time and temperature is noted. So initial temperature is with this, and final. Suppose in the second time 120 is voltage is raised to 120, and next the time taken is again, suppose 3 minutes, 3 into 60, 180 seconds, initial temperature is 35, and after 3 minutes the temperature rises to 39, then we get the difference of these two, which is 4, and the calculation of in the second time the final temperature is taken in the first time is taken as the initial temperature, and again after 3 minutes the temperature rises to 39. So now again the temperature raise in this case is 4, so 39 minus 35, which is 4. So substitute the values of as same as in the first case, then we get the efficiency. Like this we can calculate 4 or 5 values of efficiency, and take the average of the 4 values, you get the efficiency of the electric kettle. Calculation is like this. Suppose the mass of the empty kettle is 850 grams, and after taking some water into it, then the second time mass is 1725. Now subtract these two values, and the 1725 minus 850, then we get mass of the water in the kettle. So mass of the water is taken, then that is 1725 minus 850. So we get the value 875, so it converts to grams, so that divides with 1000, that is equal to 0.875. now efficiency of the kettle is m, means the subtracted values of W2 minus W1, 4 point is the standard value, into 10 cube, into theta means temperature difference, and R is the resistance, that is also standard value of the kettle, whole by V square T. V means voltage applied, like 100, 120, etc. And T is time. Suppose in case of 3 minutes, 3 into 60, that is 180 seconds. Like this, values are substituted in the formula, then we get the efficiency. This is for 100 volts, so that it is represented with eta 100. Eta 100 is equal to 104.125. After calculation, we get this value. See? Similarly, the second value is also obtained as in the first case. So in this case, the average value calculated from these 4 or 5 values, that is the final result of the efficiency of the electric kettle for different voltages. So here, for example, in this case, the values obtained is 78.03025%.